This is Pioneer's SPH-10BT. The SPH-10BT is a 1DIN AM/FM smartphone in-dash receiver with an integrated phone cradle. It also has Bluetooth for both hands-free calling and wireless streaming audio. The Bluetooth system is designed to work with your Android phone and your iPhone. It can play back MP3 and FLAC music from a USB flash drive, and the USB can be used to charge your phone. The Pioneer SPH-10BT is designed from the ground up to work with the Pioneer Smart Sync app. The Smart Sync app brings maps, messages, and music together in your vehicle. Let's take a look and see what's in the box. Okay. First up here is the wire harness, and we'll use the wire harness here to connect power and ground and speakers, all of the electrical connections from the in-dash receiver to the vehicle. Next up, we have some 1DIN radio removal tools and some install screws. There we go. Next, we have the Bluetooth microphone. Now, the Bluetooth microphone here comes on a wire about 10 feet long or so for a very flexible installation. And we have a carry case for the detachable face. Let me open the flap here. And we have the quick start guide. Be sure to download a complete copy of the owner's manual in PDF form right onto your smartphone from pioneerelectronics.com. And finally, we have the warranty card. And let's pull the receiver up out of here. There we go. The front panel of the SPH-10BT is designed to work with the Pioneer Smart Sync app and starts off with the volume control up and down right here. Next, you can cycle through your available music sources from your phone and the in-dash receiver with the music source button here. Here is the USB port to charge your phone or play back music through a USB flash drive. This is the app voice recognition button. And you can use this button to launch your favorite navigation app from your phone. Up here is the phone cradle, and I'll show you more detail about the phone cradle in just a moment. Here is the display area. Text is displayed here. And when you're connected to your phone with the Pioneer Smart Sync app, the display area here is illuminated. You can access your messages here. You can make and receive phone calls here. The home button is here. It's used to launch phone applications. Please note, the SPH-10BT does not play CDs. And of course, detachable face security. I recommend to have the phone cradle buttoned up inside the SPH-10BT in order to remove the detachable face. To operate the smartphone cradle, we'll start by removing the detachable face. Now, pull the cradle straight out until the cradle hinge is completely visible. You can see that here. The phone cradle can be adjusted a little further out or a little further back toward the in-dash receiver, whatever works best for you in your vehicle. Next, flip the phone cradle up into the vertical position and reattach the detachable face. The smartphone cradle integrated into the Pioneer SPH-10BT is designed to handle many different phone sizes and shapes and is adjustable from 2.28 inches to 6.69 inches in height. 2.28 inches to 3.42 inches in width, and a depth from 0.15 inches to 0.39 inches. The recommended weight load that the cradle can hold is a half pound or less. The smartphone cradle arms are designed to handle many different types of phone cases and still hold the phone very firmly. You may need to adjust the position of the lower arms to accommodate the side button positions on your particular phone. And in some cases, it may work better to mount your phone upside down in the cradle. To attach your phone, start by putting the top of your phone under the upper cradle arm. Next, gently push up on the upper arm until you can slide the phone in place with the lower arms. The upper arm operates on an internal spring to hold the phone very firmly in place. The Pioneer Smart Sync app can operate in both a horizontal and vertical position. To remove your phone from the cradle, gently push the phone up against the upper cradle arm until the phone could swing free from the lower arms. If you want, it's okay to leave the phone cradle in this open position when you leave your vehicle. However, if you want to close up the cradle, I recommend to detach the face and then close up the cradle. On the back panel of the SPH-10BT, the AM/FM antenna from the vehicle will plug in right here. This small black port is for the optional NDPS-1 parking sensor kit from Pioneer. The NDPS-1 is designed to operate with the SPH-10BT and with the Pioneer Smart Sync app. The wire harness with its speaker outputs and other electrical connections to the vehicle will plug in right here. On the other side, we'll start off with two black jacks. The one on top is where you'll plug in the Bluetooth microphone included with the SPH-10BT. And the one on the bottom is for operating your steering wheel controls through a third-party adapter. And here are two sets of RCA outputs for operating external amplifiers. They are 2-volt outputs and can be set up as front and rear output or as front and subwoofer output. And that is Pioneer's SPH-10BT and what's in the box.